So we try to do in both the methods. First method is point method. So add all the points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20 points are there. Clear, ma? Now let us see their velocities. So this is coming down now. So this point is responsible for increasing the length of the string. So plus 1 or minus 1? Plus 1, plus 0, plus 0, plus 1, 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 plus 1, plus 0, plus 0. So let us consider this is coming down. So plus VA, total it should be equal to 0. So VA is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So minus 9 meters per second. That's all, Rama? Any doubt in this one? So, or without calculating also, we can say how 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These 9 points are coming down. So these 9 points are responsible for increasing the length of the string. So if they are increasing the length, we take their length to be positive. Clear? So sir, that is velocity to be positive. And here what is my assumption? It is coming down. But I got value to be negative. It means body is actually moving upwards. That is our answer. Clear? Now let us try to do the same problem by using virtual work method. So have you made ochindama andarkedi? Okay. Now let us see. Okay. So second method, which is called virtual work method. Clear ma? So in this condition, the summation of all the work done by tension is zero. This is called virtual work method, no? So same tension is existing everywhere. Okay? So here tension is T. Here also tension is T here. Clear, ma? And here T, 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 and T. So on this body totally how many tensions are acting? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 tensions are acting. Clear? Or you can write here also. If this is T and T, this becomes 2T, no? Similarly, this is 2T. Artham avutundi kada? Similarly, this is 2T and this is 2T. So these two and these two tensions must be equal. Clear, ma? So now how can I write virtual work method here? For this body, tension is upwards. But body is coming downwards. So force is in one direction, displacement is in opposite direction. So total work done is positive or negative?
Negative.
Negative work done. Because angle between these two is 180. Cos 180 is minus 1. Okay. So what is virtual work method? Summation of T into V should be equal to 0. So total work done by tensional forces is 0. Clear, Numa? So there for the first body, minus T into 1. Anything you can write. Clear, ma? If force I take negative, then displacement is positive. If I take displacement to be positive, then force is negative. Anything we can take. Clear? Okay. Plus, next, what about this body? 1, 2, 3, 4. 8T is acting upwards. But body is coming. So minus... minus 8T into 1. What about this one? So let us assume this body is moving upwards. We assume this is moving upwards. Then plus or minus?
T into
VA, sir. Plus T into VA is equals to 0. That's all, Noma? Why we have taken plus T into VA here? We are assuming VA to be moving upward. This is our assumption. Understand, ma? And tension is also in the same direction. So angle between them is 0. Cos 0 is 1 plus 1. So work done is positive. Are you able to understand how we are doing? So everywhere we are checking whether work done is positive or negative. If angle between force and displacement is 180 degrees, then work done is negative. If angle between force and displacement is 0, then work done is positive. In this method, we are trying to calculate. Clear, Noma? So therefore, again, what is the answer? I got T gets cancelled. So minus 1, minus 8, plus VA is equals to 0. So therefore, VA is equals to plus 9 meters per second. So what does plus 9 indicate? No. It means what I have assumed is correct. I have assumed VA to be upwards, no? So I got positive answer. So definitely VA is moving upward. This body is moving upwards with a velocity of 9 meters per second. Clear, Noma? Understood? So try to do this problem again in both the methods. Come on, try in both the methods, virtual work done method, also do in point method. Clear? So first I will prefer virtual work method. Clear, ma? So here tension is acting in this direction. Same tension will be acting in all the strings, Noma, because this is same string. So tension everywhere will be same. Understand? No. Let us see. If we deal in two methods, you will understand which one is easier. Clear? So let us see. So here if I see, tension and displacement are in opposite direction. Body is moving like this. Minus T into 1. So minus T into 1. Clear? Now if you see this one, here also minus T into 1. Here also tension and displacement are in opposite direction. Clear, ma? But if you see in this condition, tension is in this direction. And what about velocity? Velocity I don't know. So let us assume velocity to be in this direction. So can I say T into VB?
No, sir.
I cannot take.
No, sir. T into cos
30, sir. Because I want tension and velocity to be in the same direction, no? So this velocity vector, how can I split this one? I can split this one into VB cos 37 and VB cos 37. Clear, Noma? I am assuming velocity to be in this direction, no? So this velocity vector, or I will write here, this velocity vector VB, how can I split into two components? This angle is already given as 37 degrees, no? Clear? So you split this vector along 37 degrees, like this. Okay? What is this angle? 37. So this will become VB cos 37. So this is the velocity vector which I want. Because tension is acting in this direction. Tension is acting in the same direction, no? Clear, Noma? So how can I write now? Tension is in this direction, velocity is also in the same direction. So plus or minus?
Plus.
So plus T into VB cos 37. Plus. Now we will consider this tension also. This tension is also in the same direction. VB cos 37. Now how I will split this VB? I will split differently. How I will split? So this is VB. Now I will split this VB along this line now. How can I split? I can split like this, no? So this is again 37. This is again VB cos 37. Are you able to understand, ma? So therefore, again plus VB cos 37 or minus? Plus. Again, tension and velocity are in same direction. So again, T into VB cos 37, total work done should be equal to 0. But solve. So therefore, how can I do? My T, all T values, they get cancelled. So what I will get? Minus 1, minus 1. And if I take VB common, 2VB cos 37 value is 3 by 5 is equals to 0. So 2 to minus 2 minus 2 minus 2 plus 2VB into 3 by 5 is equals to 0. So therefore, what can I write? 2VB into 3 by 5 is equals to 2. Then what I got? So VB is equals to 5 by 3 meters per second. This is my answer. Clear, Nama? So answer I got plus 5 by 3 or minus 5 by 3? Plus 5 by 3. So plus 5 by 3 means our assumption is correct. I have assumed V to be in this direction, no? So my answer is correct. Have you understood? So why we are splitting into components here, can you say? Why we are splitting this velocity into components?
Because always tension act in opposite
direction. No, no. I want always velocity and tension should be in the same straight line.
Sir, velocity is a vector quantity, sir. It is acting up and down, sir. So we can draw the same vector above that B block and we can split into...
No, no. My question is why we are splitting that vector into components? Why? Velocity and tension must be in the same straight line, not in same direction. They must be in the same straight line. What is meant by same straight line? If tension is in this direction, velocity can be in this direction, no problem. Okay? Or if tension is in this direction, velocity can be in the same direction, no problem. So both of them are in the same straight line, no? So these two are also in the same straight line. These two are also in the same straight line. Okay? So here, this is the direction of tension, no? So I want velocity vector in that direction. Clear? So that's why I have split this one into two components. VB cos 37, VB sin 37. Okay? Similarly, this vector also I have split into two components. Understood, Nama? Then have you understood what is meant by positive work and negative work? Clear, no? If tension is in this direction and velocity is in this direction, then work done is negative, not positive, because angle between them is 180. And tension is in this direction, velocity is also in the same direction, then work done is positive. Let us do the same problem by using point method. Clear? So let us see. So I will consider all the points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Just we consider velocities here. Understand? And what are the rules of considering velocities? If a point is responsible for increasing the length of the string, then that velocity is positive. If a point is responsible for decreasing the length of the string, such velocity is negative. Summation of total velocities?
Zero.
Anth. Clear? So let us see first point. This point, no? Is it increasing the length of this string or decreasing the length of this string? Point is moving down, no? So length increases. So plus 1. That's all, Nama? Next, what about this point? This is a fixed pulley. So this point and this point are in rest position. So plus 0, plus 0. What about this point? So we assume VB to be moving upwards. Now what is my assumption? VB is moving upwards. It means this point and this point, they are moving upwards, no? So are they increasing the length or decreasing the length? Decreasing the length. And what is the direction of this point? In the direction of rope, no? And what is the direction of rope here? Cos 37. So VB cos 37. Plus VB cos 37, minus VB cos 37. Minus VB cos 37. Why minus VB cos 37? Because this point is reducing the length of this string. Similarly, same point we can write for this rope also, no? Again, minus VB cos 37. What about this point? Zero. What about this point? Zero. What about this point? Plus one. Total should be equal to zero. So this point is coming down because block is coming down. So this point increases the length of this string. So positive velocity. Clear, ma? Now calculate this answer and see what is the answer you will get. So minus 2VB cos 37 is equals to minus 2. Same answer we get, no? So therefore, VB is equals to 5 by 3 meters per second. This is my answer. Emma? T by 2. Chaddam. So therefore, VB is equals to 1 by 4. So VB is equals to 2 by 4. 1 by 2 meters per second. That is my answer. Taking an example here. So this is an inclined surface, which is present on smooth surface. What is meant by smooth surface? Friction is absent. There is no friction. Clear, ma? So on this wedge, I am placing another block, another rod, anything, which can move only in vertical direction. Clear, ma? So this rod, either it can move upwards or it can come downwards, because it is present between two fixed bars here. And let us take this angle to be 37 degrees, and let us assume this is coming down with a velocity of 10 meters per second. Then I want to calculate velocity of this wedge. This is the given condition. Are you able to understand, ma? So this rod, it can either move upwards or downwards. Only two conditions are possible because it is fixed between two frames. Understand, ma? And now it is present on a wedge here. And if this one comes down, this will move in this direction, no? Because this is what type of surface? Smooth surface. So if velocity of this rod is 10, then what is the velocity of this wedge? This is the question. Free body diagrams only we are supposed to draw here. Clear, ma? Let us see. So first we draw this inclined plane here. This is the direction of inclined plane, no? Which is making an angle of 30 degrees. Now consider this rod. What is the movement of this rod? This rod is coming down, no? This rod is coming down with how much velocity? With a speed of 10 meters per second. Similarly, you consider the velocity of this wedge. Wedge is moving in which direction? Wedge is moving in this direction with a velocity of VW, no? No, I will say. Are you able to understand, ma? So this is velocity of the rod. This is velocity of the wedge. Clear? So why I am taking these two points here? Because I am supposed to draw a line which is perpendicular to the inclined surface. What is this line? This is the line perpendicular to inclined surface, not normal reaction. Just we are drawing a line perpendicular to the inclined surface. Clear, ma? Now, what is this inclined surface making an angle? This is making angle of 37 degrees, no? if this is 37, this will be 90, no? This will be 53, no? Again, these two lines are perpendicular, no? If this is 53, this is 37. Again, these two lines are perpendicular. If this is 37, this is 53. Completed, no? So this is the distribution of angles. Have you understood anything?
Yes, sir.
Artham endo burakathi vinnatlunda. Idi 37 kada. This is a right angle triangle, no? Total angle in a triangle 180. This is 37, this is 90. By construction we can understand. 90, 37, this must be 53. Idi theta avute, idi 90 avute, idi 90 minus theta avutundi. 90 minus theta is 90 minus 37 is 53. Clear? Now this line and this line, they are perpendicular, no? Why they are perpendicular? This is the inclined surface. This is perpendicular to the inclined surface. So angle between them should be 90. So if this is 53, this must be 37. Because 37 plus 53 is 90. We will say. Clear, ma? Next, this line and this line, again they are perpendicular, no? This line and this line, they are perpendicular. Again, angle should be 90. So 37 idavuta idanta avutundi 53. So this is how we have distributed the angles. Are you able to understand, ma? Now here I will say that 10 cos 37 should be equal to VW cos 53. Can you say what is the reason? These two velocities must be equal. So see what are their velocities and why they are equal. This reason you should say. So 10 cos 37 means this is 10 meters velocity, no? This one I have split along this perpendicular. What is this line? This line is perpendicular to the inclined surface. Okay, this is the inclined surface, no? To this inclined surface, this line is called perpendicular line. So this velocity vector I am splitting along this line. Then one component will be 10 cos 53, another component will be 10 sin 53. 10 sin 53 we are not considering. We are taking that velocity which is parallel to the perpendicular to the inclined surface. Understand, ma? Next, what is VB cos 53? This is VW, no? VW. No. Okay? No, let us see. This is VW, no? So, I can split this vector into two components, no? One component along this line, one component perpendicular to this line. Are you able to understand, ma? So if this is VW, I can split like this, no? This is 53, this is VW cos 53, this is VW sin 53. Clear? What is VW cos 53? It is along the perpendicular to the inclined surface. So this is also velocity perpendicular to the inclined surface. I am saying these two velocities are equal. How can I say? Why can't we say? See, ma. For example, let us see one example. So this is one body, this is another body. Clear, ma? So both of them are moving in this direction with a speed of 10 meters per second. Clear? Then if you take this line which is touching these two surfaces, which is the line which is touching these two surfaces, this is the line, no? Okay? So along this line, velocity of this body should be 10. And similarly, along this line, velocity of this body also must be 10 only. So it means velocity is perpendicular to the contact surface must be equal. Velocity is perpendicular to the contact surfaces must be equal. So let us suppose if this body is moving with 12 and if this body is moving with 10, then what will happen? Both of them are moving in same direction. This block is moving with a velocity of 12.
That will come in contact with the B, sir.
Like already it is in contact.
The relative velocity.
Think.
Sir, they go to the same velocity, sir, after certain time.
try to understand what I am saying. See, both these bodies are in contact. Clear? And they are moving in this direction. So this body's velocity is 12. This body's velocity is 10. Then what will happen? This is the question. ట్వెల్త్ వెళ్తే ఏమవుతుంది? ఇట్ డజంట్ గో విత్ 12, దట్ ఈస్ ద ఆన్సర్. ఇట్ కెనాట్ గో విత్ 12. ఇఫ్ ఇట్ గోస్ విత్ ఎ గ్రేటర్ వెలాసిటీ, దెన్ వాట్ విల్ హ్యాపెన్? దిస్ బాడీ షుడ్ పెనెట్రేట్ ఇన్ టు ద ఫస్ట్ బాడీ, అంతే కదా. ఈ బాడీ ఏమవ్వాలి? దీని లోపలికి వెళ్ళిపోవాలి. దెన్ ఓన్లీ ఇట్స్ వెలాసిటీ కెన్ బి గ్రేటర్ దెన్ దిస్ వెలాసిటీ. Are you able to understand? So what is the point we have understood here? This body's velocity can never be greater than velocity of this body. Or I can say, this is the contact surface, no? Along these contact surfaces, both the bodies should have same velocity. So perpendicular velocities to the contact surface must be same. No, point is very simple. Along the contact surface, perpendicular velocities must be equal. Then only they can move like this. So, if this body moves with a velocity greater than 12, then this body will penetrate into the first body, which is not possible. So, this velocity can never be 12. It must be equal to 10. Are you able to understand, ma? So if this is the contact surface, first body is moving with 12, second, 10, second body should also move with 10 only. So what type of velocities are they? Velocities perpendicular to contact surface. That's all, ma? So velocities perpendicular to contact surfaces must be equal. Have you understood? So here, these two velocity vectors I have split into components, no? So this 10, how can I split? This 10, I can split like this, no? What is this angle? 37. This is 10. 10 cos 37. This is 10 sin 37. Clear, no? Similarly, this velocity also I have split into two components. Understand? Now, can you say what is this 10 cos 37? What is this 10 cos 37? ఇది ఏ వెలాసిటీ? ఇది దిస్ ఈస్ ద కాంపొనెంట్ పర్పెండికులర్ టు కాంటాక్ట్ సర్ఫేస్. ఇదే కదా కాంటాక్ట్ సర్ఫేస్ ఇక్కడ. అండర్స్టాండ్? బాడీస్ ఆర్ ఇన్ టచ్ విత్ అలాంగ్ దిస్ లైన్ ఓన్లీ. అండర్స్టాండ్? సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద వెలాసిటీ విచ్ ఈస్ పర్పెండికులర్ టు ద కాంటాక్ట్ సర్ఫేస్. విచ్ వెలాసిటీ? 10 cos 37. సిమిలర్లీ హియర్ విచ్ ఈస్ ద వెలాసిటీ విచ్ ఈస్ పర్పెండికులర్ టు ద కాంటాక్ట్ సర్ఫేస్? VW cos 53. Are you able to understand? So this is the contact surface. And this component is perpendicular to this contact surface. Similarly, this velocity is also perpendicular to the contact surface. So 10 cos 37 and VW cos 53 must be equal. If they are not equal, what will happen? This condition will happen. One body will penetrate into another body, which is not possible. Have you understood? So therefore, how can I write a relation? Now we got the answer. So VW is equals to 10 cos 37 divided by cos 53. So 10 into cos 37 value 4 by 5 divided by cos 53 value is 3 by 5. 5 gets cancelled. So 40 by 3 meters per second is my answer. Have you understood, ma? So what is this velocity? This is velocity of the wedge. Clear? If this rod is coming down by 10, wedge will move with how much velocity? 40 by 3 meters per second. Here you, one point you should note down here. What you should note down? Velocities of bodies. Make a note. Velocities of bodies perpendicular to the contact surface, velocities of bodies perpendicular to contact surface must be equal. Clear ma? Which velocities must be equal? Velocities which are perpendicular to the contact surface, they must be equal. Otherwise one body will penetrate into another body, which is not possible. Clear? Okay. So very fastly try to do this problem. So this angle is 53 degrees. So this block is coming down with 10 meters per second and this block is moving in this direction. What is the velocity of this block? That is the question. Come on. So this is a frame which cannot be moved. So two blocks are arranged like this. One block is coming down with 10. Then this block will move in this direction. No? I want velocity of this block. Clear? Come on. So try to find out those velocities which are perpendicular to the contact surface. Cos 53 is 3 by 5. 30 by 4. Maybe. Same. కానీ డోంట్ డూ ఇన్ ద సబ్స్టిట్యూషన్ మెథడ్, మన ప్రాపర్ మెథడ్లో ట్రై చేయండి. క్లియర్? సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ద కాంటాక్ట్ సర్ఫేస్ మేకింగ్ ఎన్ యాంగిల్ ఆఫ్ 53. సో వన్ బాడీ ఈజ్ కమింగ్ డౌన్ విత్ 10, అనదర్ బాడీ ఈజ్ మూవింగ్ లైక్ దిస్ విత్ V. This is the line perpendicular to the contact surface. Then 37, 53, 37. So 10 cos 53 is equals to V cos 37. V is equals to 10 into cos 53 divided by cos 37. V is equals to 10 into 30 by 4. 30 by 4 meters per second. Clear ma? So this 10, how can I split this one? I can split this one into two components like this. 10, this is 53. 10 cos 53. Similarly, this velocity V, I can split like this. So this is 37, this is V. V cos 37, V sin 37. Clear ma? So this velocity I have split into two components. Similarly, this velocity I have split into two components. What is this 10 cos 53? This is the velocity perpendicular to the contact surface. Correct, no? Similarly, what is this velocity? Again, it is perpendicular to the contact surface. So these two velocities must be equal. Then only one body will not penetrate into another body. Clear, no? So that's all. Just equate both of them, I got the answer. Ante. Same. So if I change the problem, so I don't know velocity of this one and this is moving with 10 meters per second. Now calculate the answer. Sure? 4 by? Okay, ma'am, you're well and inka. ఇది ప్రాబ్లం, మీరు హోంవర్క్ తీసుకొని యు లీవ్. 40/3 చూద్దాం. సో లెట్ అస్ ట్రై టు డూ దిస్ ఆల్సో వెరీ 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 ఫాస్ట్లీ. సో దిస్ ఈస్ వి నో, దిస్ ఈస్ వి, దిస్ ఈస్ 10 నౌ. సో హౌ కెన్ ఐ రైట్? ఐ కెన్ రైట్ v cos 53 is equals to 10 cos 37. So v is equals to 10 into 3 by 5 divided by 10 into 4 by 5 divided by 3 by 5. So v is equals to 5 gets cancelled, 40/3 meters per second. This is my answer. Clear ma? Now this vector I can split like this. Clear? So this is 53, so this becomes v cos 53. Similarly, this 10 I can split like this. Like this. So this is 37, so 10 cos 37. Clear ma?